If we examine the prophets after him, such as Hud, Salih, Shu'aib, and others, alayhim as-salam, it would clearly be visible that Allah destroyed the civilization, but spared the prophets. The cities of Thamud and Ad, people were not too far apart, but travel was from one civilization to another. What we're saying is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in destroying their local civilization, merely had them leave that city. He never had them build an ark or to build a large boat or a large plane to actually leave that area. But the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam was ordered to build an ark. He was ordered to build an ark. The third problem with holding the flood to be local. Why would he have been ordered to take all of the animals aboard? Surely upon disembarking, most of, if not all, of the same species of animals would have been present to eat and take benefit from. Why would he have been told to take two of each animal, male and female, if when the ark disembarked in this next area, there would have been the same animals present? Why would he have been told to do that? The fourth point that presents a problem for holding the localized flood opinion. Why did the hadith say that not just all of humanity, when it said jami', but it said khalq? The Prophet Muhammad ﷺ said all of the khalq are descended from Nuh. The word khalq could cover animals as well, which are descended from Nuh if the flood was merely a localized punishment. What I'm saying is that it says all of the khalq. Khalq can cover human beings as well as animals. It says all of them are from the time of Nuh. So if all the animals that he took aboard the boat and all the human beings that he took aboard the boat are from the time of Nuh alayhi salam, then how could the flood be localized? It would have had to have been global. Because if we say all the people are from the time of Nuh, would we say all of humanity now is directly related to Nuh alayhi salam? Yes. Why? Because all the others were destroyed. We would say the same thing of the animals. Therefore, the flood would have had to have been global. Now, let us quote the Orthodox scholars what they have to say about this issue. Because it's not enough for me to elucidate. We have to go to proper authorities. Imam al-Husayn al-Baghawi, rahimahullah, he tells us, quote, "The intent expressed with these ayats is that all humanity, all of them, are from the genealogy of Nuh." Close quote. It's taken from Ma'alim al-Tanzil, pages 1090 to 1091. Now let's listen to what Imam ibn Atiyah, rahimahullah, has to say. Quote, "It can be judged to mean that the flood overtook his people alone. There has been much difference of opinion in that, with one group saying the flood was only for the group of people on the earth, and it was specific and restricted to the people of Nuh. Another group, and it is the majority, stated the flood was global for all people." It says the flood was global for all people. Close quote. This is taken from Al-Muharrar al-Wajiz, pages 1457 to 1458. Imam Ibn al-Jawzi, rahimahullah, stated, quote, "The boat of Nuh was filled with all the people, birds and animals." Close quote. Taken from Zadul Masir fi Ilm al-Tafsir, pages 1032 to 1033. Imams al-Mawardi and Al-Izz ibn Abdus Salam, rahimahumullah, stated, quote, "There were eight aboard the ark, Nuh, his children, and the four women. Thus all of humanity is from his descendants." Close quote. Taken from Tafsir al-Quran, pages 470 to 471. Imam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, says, quote, "And Allah in the general flood drowned all of the descendants of his, Adam, except whoever was in the ark. The people of the ark, all of their lineages were cut off, except those of the children of Nuh." Close quote. Taken from Majmu'a Fatawa, volume 7, page 92. Imam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, says at another point, quote, "And there are certain mass transmitted events, like the event of the deluge." Close quote. This is taken from Al-Aqidatul العقيدة الإصفهانية volume 1 page 133. What Imam Ibn Taymiyyah is saying, mass transmitted, is it means events that have been passed down again and again and again and again. And they have been passed down through most, if not all, societies that have reached us. These are called mass transmitted events. For example, the existence of the sun. It has been passed down innumerable times unbroken that the sun, as long as humanity can remember, has been in existence. Well, the flood, as long as humanity has been in existence, has also been passed down from person to person, and that actual flood has always been related in a global understanding. This is what Ibn Taymiyyah is trying to get us to come to terms with. The flood, when passed down unbroken, has not been passed down by the people to be local. It has been passed down to be global. Now, someone could question, but how could that be when the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam was not sent to all of the world? Because indeed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the only one sent to all of humanity. So how could it be when he was not sent to all of the world? Wouldn't that make him like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then we'd have a problem? Well, Imam Ibn Atiyah rahimahullah, he answers this. We'll take his statement. He says, quote, "And this is the most correct opinion regarding the matter, because of his being taken aboard a ship, because of his floating away when the waters submerged the area, and other than these are evidences and indications for the majority position. The one who would seek to reject this and remain upon his position would say, how could the flood be global when the messenger was sent to some? What could be said is that a prophet being sent to a nation is not a restriction, by that he does not guide other than them and call them to the unicity and uniqueness of Allah the Exalted. It is only that he does not fight against others besides his own nation, nor to spread worship amongst them. People in that time were not many based on the short period of time between them and Adam alayhi salam. So it is not impossible that his calling to the unicity and uniqueness of Allah the Exalted was to everyone, for the flood reached them due to their rejection and opposition." Closed quote. This is taken from Al-Muharrir al-Wajiz, pages 1457 to 1458. What that is telling us is that there are some prophets that were sent to one nation, but their call reached more than one group of people. We have more than just one evidence of that with Nuh. Although Nuh alayhi salam and other prophets weren't sent to the world, their message reached more than one group of people. For example, the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, if you read in Surah Yusuf when he's in jail, although his main mission was to the children of Israel, he's preaching to the two convicts that are in prison. He's preaching to the king of Egypt. The prophets Musa and Harun alayhim as-salam, they are not only preaching to the children of Israel, but to the Egyptians as well. So merely because a prophet is preaching to two groups of people does not mean that he is sent to all of humanity. And merely because his message reaches other people doesn't mean he is equal with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because some of those people that they were preaching to besides the children of Israel weren't punished for rejecting his message. He couldn't force them to the worship, he could merely present it, and then they could be held responsible for their actions. Therefore, what is being said is that although Nuh, Yusuf, Musa, Harun, they were sent to not just their own prospective peoples in terms of their message, but their message reached other people, does not mean that they weren't sent to that one group. And it doesn't mean that their message couldn't have reached other people. They were still localized prophets, although their message reached others. So this is a very important point to try to keep in mind. The next point is, a doubter could say, how could the flood have been global when water has not touched every single part of earth? Our answer could be, the Orthodox never said that the flood submerged everything.